Hello everybody and welcome once again to Running Red, the hardcore questing mod pack from Gideon Seymour. Now, the last thing we were doing is we were going to get these machines here to work. So what I did figure out is they have to connect the controller to the pneumatic pipes. So we'll turn those on first of all, because we'll need some air, as I suppose, compressed air. Turn those two on and we shall put these machines down. So these are the four machines we had to build. I actually want to take these two diamonds and this and one of these and some of this, and you'll see why in a minute. So the first thing I had to do is to put these down. So let's put the assembly table in the middle here, and this is an IO unit which I shall put down here. And that's blue. And actually, that means import. I figured this out, it took me a while actually. And let's put these two machines down here. So now we've got the laser. The laser I'm going to put behind the assembly table. And the drill I'm going to put on the corner here. So if I now go and look at this recipe, and I want to look at the recipe for making advanced pipes. So we could say, let's have a look. I think we want this recipe here, advanced pressure tube. So it says we can use an assembly table, assembly platform, an IO unit, two IO units, and an assembly laser. Now that's what we weren't asked to build. We were actually asked to build an assembly laser, an assembly drill, and assembly labor, this one. Now, this device here is rather expensive. It requires an assembly laser drill and a laser. Assembly program laser and drill to combine together. We'll give us a drill and laser. So what we have to do to sort this out is we actually don't need the drill. What we do need is another IO unit. So lucky for you, I just prepared one of these. Anyway, and now I put this one down here. And it's also an input one, and I can't change it by simply right-clicking it. So the next thing I had to do is to build a wrench. Of course, it has to be a pneumatic craft wrench, I think. We can try the ordinary wrench as well. So take that down here, put this down here. Now this one's already charged up to 4.5 bar. So if it works with this, it'd be cool, but it doesn't. We have to use the pneumatic craft wrench. And then that changes it from an input to an export. So, next thing we need to do is to make the program. The program is quite expensive. It's 8 emeralds. 8 emeralds from this mod pack require 8 diamonds. 8 diamonds are not that easy to get. There is a way we can do them, and that is to make we need something else too. We'll need a chest as an input chest. We will also need some valves, because the recipe for this, let's go back to this one here again, is we need 4 pressure chamber valves, which is made by 8 compressed iron around a pressure tube. That's why I picked up these. So here we have our 4. So I think that's all we now need. So let's go back again. In fact, you can hear it's already reached pressure. And we shall put the input chest right beside the input IO unit, or the import IO unit. And inside it, we will put pressure valves. And here we shall come along to this here now. And we should put it, I'll just turn off the NEI for a second and you can see problems. There's no program to run. Well, we'll put the program in here. And you'll see, as I do that, it starts to work. So the first thing it does is takes the 4 valves and puts them on the assembly table. Now we'll say, while this is happening, the first time I did this, it's all crashed. the game crashed. I couldn't recover, I had to go and restore. So I did it again. Now you can see it's going to cut these up with the laser. You see it's got a little laser icon on the front of it. It's sweet, isn't it? And then it's made them fairly quickly, actually. It can go faster, this process. And the export arm or IO unit takes them away. And puts them into our chest. Interesting enough, it doesn't actually return back to its starting position, but the controller still says running. Now it says standby, that means it's finished, so we can go and get our 8 advanced pressure tubes. Let's now go back to the quest book, right click this, manual detect because it didn't detect them automatically, and claim reward. So now let's have a look what we've got. We have an epic reward back, that's fantastic. That means we shall get something useful, I hope. And we get a B plus reward, another redstone jetpack, which in fact is a great reward because you can't craft these in this game or in this mod pack. But I've already got two, so it's not so useful for me. Right, so that's done. We can now go and turn off this gas here, or the compression chamber, so they don't keep going hiss all the time. And let's look at the crafting recipe book again. So now we've got this one to do, running red. And here we get the row and door key. So we've now got to submit 25,000 life essence into the quest delivery system. Well, that's certainly not going to be a problem. We've got a chest on top of this, and this is a portable tank, I think. Do you know what? I'm not sure exactly which one it is. Let's just turn this on and shift that. Hold up. So it's an 8K one, which means I'd have to fill this up 4 times. So let's not do that. Let's go and do something else. Let's upgrade it a bit. And we'll upgrade it in here, I think, because we've got plenty of mobs. Let's take that one out. Another 600 hives, let's have it. And let's do some blood gathering. Let's find new words for this every time I do it. I remember there were quite a lot of mobs in here. And because of, oh, I didn't show you something else, but I'll show you that now. Yes. You'll see here I put down some cursed earth. In fact, I put down about 6 in here and about 3 in that corner. I didn't have time to put any more down. I was getting attacked before I could even do it. Now, with the cursed earth, I don't have to be 18 blocks away for mobs to spawn, as you can see. These must be spawning at the time. Get rid of that one, and let's get rid of this spider. I think he's, where's he gone to? Over there. And we can check that now, it should be empty. And there's a creeper. Now, so the creeper's already formed, as it were, spawned. So, what were we doing? Now, how much life essence have we got in here? That's difficult to see, since I've got my signal of magnetism on. Hopefully I pronounced it correctly today. Actually, just put those like that. Bones, bows, bows. Okay, I think that's everything I want to get rid of in here. I'll turn this off this time. Oops, try again. Zombie, get rid of this. Creeper, isn't it? Yes. But there is another zombie in there, I can hear him. So we now need to see, yes, I wanted to check how much we've got in here, so let's take the divination signal and have a look at what we have. 21,000. And I think, let's have a look, I've forgotten exactly what it is. That was a shape crafting. 5,000 will make it 16k. And oops, try again. Let's try the usage of this one. 15,000. So we just need 15,000 in the altar, so we can get that to really. We should get, when that's finished, a 32 resonant portable. No, it's the one before. Reinforced portable tank. So in here, everything's empty, of course, and everything's getting put down here. So those two bows I put back should, in fact, come into this chest. And I've got quite a lot in here. Let's get rid of some of these. Let's take the unenchanted ones. Let's make a and bring those together so that we have a. Oops. Yes, I have still got 10 million LP in the network. And efficiency, I don't really care about, to be honest with you, in terms of bows. We've got rather too many as it is already. The rest of those are enchanted, aren't they? I know there's two more up here, which I can't do yet. Let's just get these done. Okay, two boats there, complete. Let's take these two out of here and combine these three. I did actually the same. I did the same thing with the other mob spawner. I put some cursed earth down. Let's get those last two sorted out. Might make enough for a complete one. Yes. And what I wanted to do was to really take away these. Don't really belong here at the moment. Okay. So I'll just put these away quickly. Now they want to be in the pulverizer, which will be full, but may have enough capacity for these. Not quite enough space in there for anything at the moment. Plenty of dirt, which I do need. I'll just put these 16 tin orbs in there for the time being, even though it's not the right place and I don't really want them in there. So let's put these bows away. They belong in this end chest here. And you'll find some of these are actually quite good. These aren't particularly good. Power 2 and breaking, see, power 2, breaking 1, power 1. So the reason we could combine those and make power 2, power 3, power 4, power 5, etc, etc. And I don't want this in here. In fact, let's go and put the pneumatic craft tubes away for that matter. In fact, this will go up to 7 bar. A 5 bar by itself. Okay, so I could connect these across to here and then have this charging station so that it goes up to 10 bar and this valve after that, but I won't do that now. I might do that off camera at another time. Let's put these two devices in here. Another big bang from the creepers, which in there. And let's just quickly have a look and see if this is finished. Well, I don't think it's finished yet. So much blood have we got in the altar? 17,000. A little bit longer, I think. Right. In the meantime, I need to clear my inventory a little bit more. Let's put some of this stuff away. Now this chest is getting a bit full. What I'm going to do here is I'm going to, let's do that now in fact. That's an iron chest. In fact, I've got two iron chests which I need to upgrade and I haven't got enough gold. So two iron chests. gold we have plenty of, but not just in that chest. So 64, actually let's take that 41. And all I need to do is go around the outside of there. It doesn't matter if I got too many, because I've only got two iron. I put that down there. So let's upgrade this chest first of all. Simply right click with that upgrade. And the other one I want to do is the B one, because the B's are also full. In fact, this is the one here. As you can see, it's already full. So let's upgrade that. Gives me a few more slots, and then I can put away some of the B stuff as well. Actually, I've only got one frame on me at the moment. I've had six hives, of course. Right. And the rest I have to go and put away. I want to do some more work with the bees, which I want to show you today. Oops. Try again. Now what I want to do is get my jetpack on. Just put those items I don't want in here. They were compressed steel, that's right. Okay. And what else did I have on me that I wanted to get rid of? Oh yes, these things over here. This is where I keep sort of odd things. And this is where I keep the blood magic stuff. Well, I'm going to put this up here and hopefully remember where it is. And the rest buckets, I shall give it to this portable tank, don't want that one. Probably don't want this, but that doesn't belong there either. Let's put this in the right place, which is here. That shears it was, wasn't it? I wanted to get rid of the right. This looks like I'm not sure what that was. Is it grey? Let's have a quick look at portable tank in any eye. So turn that back on again. F to go to the bottom and then type in port A. So it could well be a hardened portable tank, but we want the reinforced portable tank. Because that's the one that gives 32. That's slightly darker. Figure it out. 13,000 from 27,000. It must be nearly done. But I don't want to leave it too long, because otherwise it'll turn into a resident portable tank. But at least we can quietly eat down while we're here. Pick some more junk up, of course. The chest at the back, of course, is also the tank at the back is also full. Right, let's just get rid of those bits that I didn't want to pick up. Of course, it gets difficult to calculate now. We're up to 30,000. But while we're waiting, we can eat as well, of course. Don't know how long that's going to take. While that's cooking, let's go and do the other thing I want to do. And that is in here, centrifuge. When you've just centrifuged honeycomb, you get honey and beeswax. Now, with the honey, if we centrifuge, squeeze this, there's a chance of getting something called propolis. And propolis is the thing that we need to make the aprius pipe. Yes, I want to go and get some more bits, but they were from here. So we have now three. Outronic gates and a gate. Now what I could do with bees, of course, is to basically be able to turn on off the motor as it needs to be. So Here we have a redstone engine. In fact, before I go trundling over, let's double check this thing now, see if it's finished. Well, I'm going to leave it. If it turns into a resonant portable tank, it doesn't matter. So let's come here and have a look. What have we got? So this is actually chocolate frames. So I don't want to do those. And this is just ordinary frames. So in fact, what I will do is I'll take out the chocolate frames from here and the bees, and I'll take out the ordinary frames from here and these bees. I want to put those impregnated frames back again in here and the chocolatey frames in here. And then come around the back and start to automate this. Oh, I do remember we needed something else now, think about it. I'll take the B-Elizer. We need some cobblestone pipes because we do not want the stone pipes to join. And when you've got cobblestone pipes and stone pipes together, I haven't got any cobblestone here. Let's just take one of those. Oh, we've got two cobblestone. Well, strangely enough, there is no shortage of cobblestone. Not too far. Right, here we have our cobblestone. Now, there is something else, and that is in here. I've got this set up, and I'm short of one diamond. I think I've got a diamond, actually. No. Has that reward finished? Let's just check. Let's go back. Yes, we've got an unclaimed reward for this one. So the usual notch apple. And now I have my diamonds. What I want to make in here is an APRIS database. I'll just put the diamond. Everything else was prepared, as you can see, one glass plane, so everything should leave three tin when it's finished. And this is a complementary to the B-Elizer. And this stores information of what you've been doing. In fact, while I was doing that, let's have a look at this bag. Four bread and four seeds. Actually, not too unuseful for a change. Let's put the seeds straight away in here. You see, I did get three propolis. So let's squeeze some more comb. And we really need four, but three will do for the time being. We've got six sticks, which is not enough for anything. But I don't want to fill up my inventory too much. Let's just get rid of this copper orbis. In fact, I want to make sure that copper orbis are blacklisted in there, and I can put them in here and they should go straight into the trash. Let's get that B-Elizer. That should have finished by now. Yes, here we go. So now when we look at this, let's get the B-Elizer into position here. It tells me all of the bees have actually produced, which is great. Every bee I've analysed has come into here. So now I can see diligent. And I should be able to see more information. Why can't I see more information here? Oh, that's strange. Cultivated. Okay, so something like don't ask me why. It's probably because I haven't analysed the diligent bee. So what I was going to do now is to take out two of these. We only need two of these actually, and I want one of those. In fact, I've already got some propolis, so let's take two of these out. Now these are diamond, pipes. Diamond pipes exactly the same as cobblestone, except for the fact you use two diamonds instead of two stone like this. That's the recipe we're going to make next. And this was made right just like that. So maybe with a bit of luck I can do that. Wish I can. Shift right clicking actually worked for a change. Now, so what we do is move stuff out of the way so we can actually do what we want. So a cobblestone, wood and a prism pipe, and let's put the wood down here and here, and on top of the wood we'll put the cobblestone. You see that doesn't join, but as a demonstration let's just take out one stone, put that on here, so the cobblestone, it then joins into this, which I don't really want. I prefer it to go into the apris pipe. So we now put the cobblestone down here, it doesn't join onto that. Come around the front, let's put these two apris pipes down, one here, and you'll see that these do join together, which is actually what I do want. So what I want is the bees to come from this back into here and everything else going out into here. So that's the red output. So let's click this here. So black was bees, any bees, and the red is anything else. And it's exactly the same on this side here. I want bees going into here, and blue in this particular case is everything else. You see blue. So now I just need some power, or pumping as it were. So of course we've now got these, I can't pronounce this word, I'm going to give up, these gates, and I'll put one of these on here. In fact I'll do this one first, turn it on. So here it says items in the inventory to send an energy pulsar, so that'll basically send everything out of that was in here out. Well, we've moved everything anyway. This one, if I take the normal gate here and put that down here, you can do the same thing. You can say items inventory, then give you a red signal empty, but in fact it's a bit strange. Cars space in inventory, items traveling pipe empty, red zone signal blah. Ah, missing drone. Ah, I can do no frames. I didn't know that. So a missing queen or princess, that might be a good choice actually, because who's got that, then it means it's got nothing in the in here, and right? They generally come in last. So let's put the motor on here, so it's nice and nigger and so signal. So this redstone engine should start to work. Oh no, it's turned off. Let's have a look in here, what have we got? Well, it's got a princess. Let's just check this gate again. So that should, oh, redstone signal, I didn't tell it to put redstone signal. So now this is going to pump and bring everything out. And the first thing it does is the cones. And then it should do the drones, and then it'll do the princess, I think. And you can also see it changing colour. Alright, let's go back over here. Now, of course, these cones are coming into here. And hopefully the bees will be near, just about ready. Yes, now it's taking the drones. And now it's taking the princess. And what should happen is the princess should come in here and the drone should come down here. 17, 18, that's correct. 2, 1 princess. And then the light goes off because we do have a princess. So the motor then stops, which is actually exactly what we want. So, and maybe I can do the same on these ones as well. That was all. So then that turns itself off because it doesn't need to run. So this has got a missing print, which of course is correct. I wonder, because one thing I couldn't do before was to feed these automatically with impregnated frames. I thought that was an arbitrary special function. But if there are, then we could be, when we could get clever, we could actually join these two together and put another unit on here which says if it's, well, I don't know how that's going to work. I'll have to do some looking into that. So right, let's go back here. Let's get my BLizer out here and let's have a look. We did find a diligent princess. Now this diligent princess here, let's look at number 5, get the, get the BLizer. This is actually a purebred diligent princess, so that was first time. So what I now need is some diligent drones. What have we got in here? These were the ones which came out of these hives. So that's a forest common, and that's a common common, so that's pretty useless one. These are commons. This is a common diligent. And this is a common pure common as well. And this one is a common noble. So these actually could be interesting. Because after the cultivated bee, the next one that comes along is one of those two bees. Let's have a look, what have we got in here? Have we got any more? What we could try is to put a common princess in here with this diligent princess. Maybe I should really be using a cultivated princess, but I don't have any at the moment. These are the meadows ones, let's just put that back. This is the commons. And that's cultivated. Okay. Never mind, I showed you what I was set out to show you. Let's put this stuff back in here now. And of course you see now seen the difference between these two gates. It's a little bit more expensive, but you've got one block at the back less. But it works exactly the same way. So I need to go back here and put in a princess. So I've got a diligent princess, but I won't use that. I'll put her somewhere safe for the time being. And we need some way of getting a, what have we got here? Cultivated drones. Unknown varieties. That's a cultivated forest, cultivated forest. But these three here, or four, are pure cultivated. So what we can do, this one, we can put the forest princess with the drones. Now, unfortunately, I can't get these drones to go in at the same time because they're slightly different. This one here is a slower worker and this is a fast worker. So let's get rid of this one. Basically that they're less productive. So I'll take these two out of here. And now we shall wait patiently to see if we get a I'll put this in here as well, and the BLizer and the database. I wonder if the database is now updated since I've analysed that diligent. Oh, and there you see I've got a noble as well. Yes, it says diligent, but it, I know it's correct. And this one produces stringy comb, which is also a very useful thing. So it doesn't actually know that it's how I made the diligent, probably because I didn't create this early enough. And here you go, so you got your forest and your meadows makes a common, and then discovered species. We only have forest and meadows as species at the moment, I think. That's a bit strange. And here we can make cultivated. We do actually know how we make curves, common and but that doesn't show us either. Probably for the same reason. Anyway, enough of my chattering on. I shall come back next time. I think I've covered everything I wanted to do today. But there is one interesting item I would like to make. And that is, let's go and get this portable tank here. Oh yes, it did turn into a resonant portable tank at the end of the day. You can tell it's greeny. And now we could take this and put this on the Quest delivery system. However it's gone to. Shall I complete this quest now? To make the video a bit longer than I wanted it to be. Oh, it's on the back here, isn't it? Here we go. And now we have to do this, of course. Let's go to the book. Let's go back to Headfirst of Halos and this one here. We did this one already. Getting foggy is this one. So I have to select this task first of all, so that we know we've got to submit those. Right, that's now ready. And we've got plenty of buckets. No shortage of buckets, there's 16. How many do we have to submit? Was it 35? 25. Okay. 16 plus 9 is 25. Let's do that like that. Let's go to a supply of blood, which is here, look. Simply right click this until I can't get any more. That's 9. Try again. I've got space for more. 2 more. Okay. Now let's submit this one. Let's have a look at the quest book first of all. Make sure it's actually working. 0%. What's wrong with that then? Menu submit. Ah, I can be dozy at times. We all know what's wrong with that. It's an input chest. I need to make this an output chest. An output tank. Sorry, now you saw the liquid disappear. And we have 4%. Great. So that means it's working as designed. We can move a few of these around, do 4 at a time. I don't really need to keep track of this, even though the buckets are piling up, as it were. Oops. Because the quest delivery system will tell me exactly how many I've got. So I think there's about 8 or something. Let's have a look. 68%. Let's take another 9. We can always put them back in here anyway, at any time. I'm sure you've been paying more attention to what I've been doing than I have, so let's just check this now. 84%. If I do it slowly enough, they will. Should be 92, 96. That should be about 100%. Yes. Now I can claim my reward. This time I get a yellow heart canister. Wow. Way down the book, and the Roman door key, a full heart, 8 notch apples, and a reward bag. Let's have a look at what we've actually got. And then, obviously, squid made me jump. I'll put this down here. Let's have a look at the reward bag. Let's have a look at my spaces for this one. So now I should get a yellow heart down the bottom. Look at this reward bag. A B plus reward filled sockets 8. Oh, it's actually a pretty good reward, that one. That's a lot of blood. 23 lives. And now we need to submit this key. Now there's a door here. Let's go and see if we can find it. Let's write down these positions. And let's go to the map. And let's make a marker. Quests, here we go. And let's make a marker in here. Oops, sorry. Right click, wasn't it, for a marker. Marker name. Let's say door. Quests, and it was -550, wasn't it? And it was 50 high. It's a bit low, but and then it was 2286. Was it 2386? I'll just check it. Where did that go to? Here. It seems to be about right. Let's see if we can select that, make the colour differently. What shall we give it? At the moment it's red, let's make it blue. Now, is there a blue marker about? We can't see it on this, of course. Let's go back to the map and zoom in. I think we can zoom in with... How do we zoom in? I'm not that way. Help. I think it's actually scrolling. Yes, that is. It's scrolling, so it's almost there. It's somewhere here, I think, is a row and door. 51. 2286550. This must be. Oh, that's exactly where I built this door. Well, that's a shame. I suppose it's supposed to be here. Anyway, I shall say goodbye, and until next time, bye for now.